Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to share with you another interesting facade design in Revit. The facade design is Gallery of Logistics and Auxiliary Services in Spanish. I thought it would be interesting if I can produce this kind of facade and give you a quick tip to create that. So today we're going to create those complex shapes together, but before I get things started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reaching out to my channel and you want to learn more about Revit, make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for all notifications so you won't miss my future tutorial. Okay, it's pretty much. Let's speak into our project together. Okay, here we are in Revit's architecture template. So basically, a lot of my previous tutorial, I got talking about how to use our curtain panel family in order to get our pattern. So today I'm going to give you another quick tip that we use our curtain panel transfer to our facade, and of course we got our structure to support for our facade also. So the tutorial, I think I will be make it as fast as can. Now here I am in Revit's architecture template. So what I'm going to do in order to create our complex facade design, first thing I'm going to our file here, then go to our new, go to our families as away. Of course we will be using for our curtain panel wall, this guy over there that I can open up. Once I open that, Revit will be transforming me to another page. Okay, once we open our curtain panel, Revit will be open 4 pages for us. The first one we want is the 3D and exterior and legs and reference level. So I'm going to working our reference level first. So first thing, I'm going to our reference level, then I'm going to select my line here. I want to adjustment here, and I'm going to give our structure for 450. So mean our total length is about 900. Then I'm going to give in another reference plane in order to get a parametric for our facade also. RP for shortcut key. Then I just placing here like this and another guy like this. And of course, in order to create our parameter for dimension, we need to give a dimension also, DI for dimension. Then I straight away like this, make it equal. And of course, I will try make it like this. And this guy over there, I just simply give another one like this. Hit escape a couple times. Then I can go to my family tile here. Then of course, I will make our width and length same amount. So I'm going to, I need to assign for a new parameter first. Create a new parameter. Just give this one for width. Okay, then I'm going to give this guy over there for length, L-E-N-G-T-H. Then go to our family type. Then I'm going to make our length, make it like this for formulas. Okay, once you done that, it's time to create our structure. First thing, let me show you our structure first. Okay, as you can see, our structure is something like this. Basically, our structure is something like this. It's something like this. So we will get another two panel. One is glass panel and another one is our wall for structure. And of course, as you can see on our photo reference here, we got some kind of, let's say I will consider this one is aluminum composite material, is alugabond. And this guy over there, I'm going to consider this one is a glass panel. Laminate glass is about 25 mm, I think, just my consideration. And of course, here I just give you a quick concept to create that. So let's speak into our Revit family. Let me hit escape first, go back to my Revit family. Okay, so now it's time to create that. First thing, I'm going to create that by using our create tab, then go to our extrusion, start from point here. I will start from point here until here, just make it like this, hit escape. Then I'm going to use our pick line, and I will consider our thickness about 100 mm. Just make it like this, hit escape a couple of times. Once I done that, in order to make our extrusion, I need to lock that and make it boundary. Just make it like this. Then I need to trim it. Hit escape a couple of times. Once I done that, I haven't finished my job here yet. I need to assign for material and create our extrusion. Also, I will make it for 4 meter extrusion from our reference until our top. And of course, I will assign for new material parameter also. Just make this guy over there for wall panel. Then I can okay. Once I done that, I can go to my family tie. Then I will give it a quick material, just make it for white color. Okay, so I'm going to create another new material tie. Sorry, I need to create new. Then I'm going to rename it, just make it for wall panel. Like this, go to our apparent library. Make sure I'm going to turn on for use render appearing. Go to our apparent library. Then I'm going straight away, make the color for white color like this. Hit apply, then hit okay. Once I done that, I can apply again and hit okay again. So I just hit finish up. Then I can go to my create tab again, go to extrusion. It's time to create our glass panel. Just start from corner here. I will make it straight like this. Okay, I think we make it for 30. Yep, like this. Then I'm going to extend it, just hit a pick line. Then pick it for 25 millimeter. Yep. Then I'm going to connect that. Just make it close as well. Okay. TR trim. Actually, you can extend also for TR. Just make it like this. And this guy over there, I'm going to extend. Hit escape a couple times. Of course, same thing, we need to create a new parameter material also. Just make this guy over there for glass panel. It's okay. Once I done that, I'm going to our family type. Then go to our glass panel material. Assign a new material as well. Then I'm going to use our glass here, apparent. I'm going to make this guy over there, chain material. Just make it for blue. I think I will create another material. It's better. It's a better choice. Rename, just make it for glass panel. Then go to our color there. Train it to something like this. Make it more thicker. Apply, it's okay. Apply, it's okay. Once I done that, I just hit finish up. In order to make a parameter, I need to go to my exterior side. Let me zoom in first. Okay, so I need to lock it actually. I just lock it like this. Just drag it out and draw it up. Okay, then go to my 3D here. Okay, as you can see here, it has changed one to consistent color. Okay, so now it's time to transfer into our project. Just go to load and load into our project. And of course, if you are first time create that, you need to sell your file. But in my case, I have sell already before, so I'm just leave it like this. Now it's time to create our glass panel. As our remember, our facade design got some kind of SEM and some kind of glass panel. So in order to make it, you need to manually and complete it by yourself. But I will give you a quick tip to create that in order to make it quite professional with your facade design. Let's say I want to create some kind of wall first. In order to make it, WA on my keyboard for shortcut key. Then I will make our level until 4 meter. Then I can start here like this. Just make it about 90 meter. Hit escape a couple times. Once I done that, I can change it to our storefront. Because I don't want my storefront effective. So I'm going to duplicate my storefront here. Just duplicate. Make it for facade panel. It's okay. Once I done that, I need to adjust one sitting inside my curtain panel there. I will make our vertical spacing for 4 meter and make our horizontal grid is about 900 millimeter, same as our profile. Hit apply, then hit okay. Once I done that, let's go to our 3D there. And here I can close first actually. Okay, as you can see here. Okay, I think I need to adjustment because I have give wrong instruction already. Make our vertical and make our horizontal 4 meter. It's apply. as you can see here. Then I can change this guy over there from curtain panel profile, change to our profile that we created before. It's a family tool. Hit apply, then hit okay. As you can see here, it's quite nice. We got our mullion for system, and we got our facade design here. As you can see here, let me turn on for realistic, I think. Okay, as you can see here, as I remember, our facade design for here, we got our some kind of aluminum panel. So how could we do that? Let's say I need to extend it, because this one is just for level 1. So I'm going to extend it for 12 meter. As you can see here, now you can manually change that. Actually, I can hit tab key, then I can manually change it. I can unpick here and I can change this one material to another material, but make sure you need to duplicate your family tool here in order to change that. And of course, as you can see here, our mullion is quite bigger for spacing. I can change my mullion is quite smaller than that actually. So in order to change that, I can select one of my mullion here, just make it like this, then unpick here, go to my div type, then I can make our dimension here, just make it 10 and make here by 10 or so. And for thickness, I just leave it like this and apply. It's okay. As you can see here, it's become smaller. I don't want to see my structure inside my curtain panel here for facade here. I just like my one of my mullion here like this, then SA for select all element, then I just like VHEG for hidden element. So once I select my shortcut key all of them, my mullion here will gone. As you can see here. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for the tutorial. Here's just a quick concept for you guys, create your parametric facade in Revit. Thanks you guys for watching, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.